Hey, hey, everybody. It is time to make art. Woo! Okay, so you have your little dark dude here. You have white crayons and you have water-based markers. That means that Sharpies are out of the game this time, boys and girls. And if you're unsure if your markers are water-based, go take them to an adult and ask them if they are. Now, you guys that are at school, the first thing you need to do is take your little darkness man, flip him over, and write your name on the back, ladies and gentlemen. It's the first thing we do before any project that we ever make. And I know that I haven't been teaching you that, but as soon as you come back to my class, we write our names on everything. It's the very first step that we do. And the second step we do is take your white crayon and press really hard and draw some stars all over your darkness. Now let's talk about stars. When you draw a star, you draw a lowercase t, and then on top of it, you draw an X. It's really super duper easy. So you're just gonna draw those all over your little dark dude, and then you want to maybe do a couple of little circles. I think that makes it look cool. So here I go, fill him up. Also, make sure when you're drawing those stars that you're drawing them all over your darkness guy, because he needs to have stars everywhere, not just in one spot. Next step, you're going to take your black marker. It's very important that you use black, and you're going to lightly color with it all over in random spots. You don't want it to be too dark. You want to leave quite a bit of white showing through. Next step is to get another color. Now we're making darkness, okay? So you don't want to choose colors that don't really make sense with dark. You don't want to do yellow or orange. I would even say pink wouldn't be a very good color. I would stick with the dark colors. So that would be blue, violet, red, violet, those types of colors, turquoise. So here I am, I'm filling them all up. Oh, and I finished. Now this is when the magic happens, guys. You're going to need a paintbrush or a paper towel and a small little thing of water. Roll your paper towel up and just use the very tip. See how the tip of my paper towel is wet? And then take that wet paper towel and you're gonna dab it all over your guy. You're not rubbing, you're just dabbing. So see how I'm showing you? It's just kind of like your wet paper towel is jumping all over onto that area where you've colored. And it doesn't matter if you get outside of the lines because we're gonna cut him out later. Yay, I'm finished. Now, if you notice that a part of your coloring is too dark, you can use the dry side of your paper towel to kind of sponge that away. And now it's time to work on our background. So you're gonna get a piece of construction paper. Make sure you turn it horizontal, I mean that side to side. And then what we will be doing before we do anything, remember we put our name on the back. Woo! All right, now we're creating sort of like a picture frame. So we're only gonna be working with the outside of our paper. We're creating a border, okay? So you're only allowed to do this next step on the outside edge, which will be our border.
Patterns in the air, patterns everywhere. Patterns made of shapes, patterns made of grapes. Yeah. Patterns on the cheetah, patterns on my feeder. Patterns in the nap, patterns in this rap. Oh. That's right. Make a pattern, let's make a pattern. All right, cool. Make a pattern, let's make a pattern. Okay, here's one. Banana, banana, meatball. 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 Banana, banana, meatball.
You got it.
Turn it up. Yeah, we're making a pattern. A pattern. A pattern on our border. All right, all right.
Okay, so the way I like to do patterns as a picture frame, because that's what we're making, I like to start on the outside edges first. So you can see I started with a star in my corners, and then the next line I did was a wavy line, and the line in the shape after that was a spiraled circle, and then finally I finished the insides with a big red star. So there's all kinds of ways to make patterns like this. You figure out yours, it'll be a-okay, whatever you do. That's all for today, boys and girls. You have two sheets of paper. Make sure your name's on the back of both of them. If you didn't quite get to where you needed to be within your class period, it is fine. We all work at different paces, and you'll have next week to work on it. Love you bunches. Have a good week. Bye.
Make a pattern, make a pattern, let's make a pattern. Okay, here's one. Banana, banana, meatball, banana.